Hey guys, my name is Massimio, and welcome to an episode of Sunday Millbox. This is a video series where you, the viewer, can submit your gaming-related questions, and then I'll give my humble opinion on them. To get the formatties out of the way real quick, if you would like to submit your own question that could be featured in an upcoming episode, you can do so by leaving a comment down below, or by sending me a Facebook or Twitter message. The first question for today is, would you like it if Ubisoft introduced a new shield operator in Rainbow Six Siege? So every time a new DLC releases, I always ask the question, when are we getting a new shield operator? I mean, I'm not someone who actually plays as shields very often because I will fully admit I'm not very good with them, but you would think after 2 years we would eventually get one for the offensive team. Well, it seems like we now know the reason why this hasn't happened yet. So according to their recent AMA, the reason why we haven't gotten one yet is that right now shields have the problem where in the first person camera perspective, it has the perception that you have a wider angle of protection. I'm assuming what they mean by this is that I'm sure you guys have had these moments when you're playing as, let's say, Blitz, for example. You're in a 1v1 situation, you're facing the enemy, it seems like your shield should be able to block all the shots, and then seemingly out of nowhere, they get a headshot against you. You then watch the replay, and they were able to strafe around, you weren't aiming directly at them, and then they were able to line it up and take you out. It's incredibly frustrating when that happens. And so I think that's what they mean. It looks like you should be protected by your shield, that first person camera indicates that you should be fine, but because it doesn't give you the correct view, that's when you get taken out. I'm guessing that's the thing that they're trying to solve. The thing is, though, is that they've also stated that this isn't going to be an easy fix. It's going to take them a while for them to wrap their head around this issue and find a solution. And so while they have every intention of bringing in new shield operators, it's gonna be a while. And so I know this might come as a disappointment for a lot of you because there's some shield mains out there who would love to have someone else to play around with. I get why Ubisoft is taking the stance. I would rather them ensure that there isn't any large glaring issues so that when we finally do get someone, there isn't these systemic problems. The next question comes from Harvey, and it is, do you think the pistols are too overpowered now in Rainbow Six? They got a recoil buff in the recent DLC and now they are all like machine pistols. I have been very surprised at how many people have been expressing concerns that pistols are now too good since this update. And while I fully admit that this has been a significant improvement to the secondary weapons, not having to deal with that visual recoil has made it a lot easier for shield operators, and especially Cav, to be way more successful. Blitz has seen a really nice buff since this update. Like, it has made certain operators a lot better, but I don't know if this has made them overpowered. When you use the word OP, I think of two different ways to interpret it. Either they're so good that you're not going to want to use anything else, and I definitely don't think that that's happened. When I'm using my primary, I'm at an advantage against someone who's using a secondary. Like, they have to outskill me, they have to outclass me, they need to be the better player if they want to come out on top. My primary weapon is going to be way more powerful and way more effective. So I don't think that that's happened. Now, the other way you can interpret it is that pistols are now so good that they compete with those primary weapons. Like, they're not necessarily overpowered, but they got too much of a buff, and there's not enough a distinction between primaries and secondaries. And I think that is a distinction that they need to have. I also don't think that's the case. You even compare them to the machine pistols. I would much rather use the SMG-11 or the SMG-12 compared to any of the other secondary weapons. It's not even a competition to me. And so just in general, I've been really happy with the recoil changes. It's made these weapons a lot more reliable, it's made certain operators a lot more viable, and I think all in all, that's been a good thing for the game. The next question comes from Ryan, and it is, what do you think about a new operator in Siege that has beanbag shells for incapacitating the enemy, paired with the ability to collect and extract an incapacitated defender, preventing the opposing team from using the captured defender on their next defensive round? Well, I will give it to you that this is a very creative idea. I've never gotten a suggestion like this for Sunday Mailbox. The concept of downing someone with these beanbags, then putting them on your back, running outside really quickly, and then you kind of put them in timeout. And so for the rest of the match, the rest of the game, that team can no longer use that specific operator. That sounds somewhat intriguing. I think in reality, though, this really wouldn't have that much impact on the match. Let's say, for example, in a best case scenario, you down Ella at the beginning of a ranked game. You time her out, you put her into the state where that side can no longer use her. Like, that seems pretty good. But they're only going to be on defense maybe 1, 2, or 3 times after that if you go into overtime. Like, is that really going to provide that much of a benefit for your team? Let's say you don't down anyone at the beginning of the ranked game. Well, then you just didn't do anything for your team. You could have played as Thermite, Thatcher, Hibana, something that would have been worthwhile to get the victory for that specific round, but instead you went for, like, this long game meta, and maybe you're onto something. Maybe Ubisoft is gonna start to add in operators where it impacts the long-term gains. So you choose kind of maybe a weaker choice at the start, but it has this snowball effect that helps you out later on. Like, you could be onto something here, but I think it would just be way more beneficial to play an operator that's going to help you win the game now, win the round that you're playing currently, and not some distant benefit that you might get into the future. And then finally, I just don't know how feasible this is. If you're playing ranks, you only got 3 minutes. If you need to down someone and then run them outside, those are valuable seconds. You're not playing the objective. If there's only 20 seconds left, you finally down someone with your beanbags, you have to make the choice. Am I going to play the objective or am I going to run this guy outside? Of course you should be playing the objective. And so maybe they could get around this by just doing something like they do with Cav, where you interrogate them, you go through a quick little animation, you handcuff them or something like that. Like, that could be the workaround. I just don't know if I'm entirely sold on it. And so all in all, while this is really creative, I would be intrigued to see if Ubisoft would even consider creating an operator like this. It really sounds like the MOBAs, League of Legends and Dota. You have someone that is weak at the beginning, but then they snowball, they have some sort of benefit or effect that gives your team an edge into the future. You play the long game. Like, that could be a direction that they take for Rainbow Six Siege, but I don't even know if that is something that Ubisoft is even considering right now. I don't know if this is something that the community would even want. And so it's really hard to say if we would ever get something like this in Siege. The next question comes from Katie, and it is, do you think they should add a ranking system in Siege where you could become a top rank with certain operators? Based on how well you earn points by helping your team, you could earn top 1,000, 100, 10, etc. This would earn you unique skins each season. So conceptually, I really like the idea of having some sort of way that would allow players to show off their main operators. Like, if you really love to play as Thermite, he's your jam, you play really well with him, it'd be really cool if you could have a specific Thermite skin that basically indicated, hey, I put a lot of time into this guy, I'm really good, or at least, you know, I love this character, and that would be really cool. Now, the problem that we run into, though, is that I feel like as soon as they implement something like this, where they start to reward people for being really good with Thermites or putting a lot of time into them, we run into the problem where people are going to start to main operators even more than they do right now, and I don't know if that's the direction that we want for Rainbow Six Siege. Imagine for a second you're with a bunch of random players and you have one guy in your team that only wants to play as Thermites. You might be thinking, well, what's wrong with that? Thermite's fantastic. You need to have him on offense. He's arguably one of the most important people that you can have. If he wants to get that exclusive Thermite skin for that season, well, what's the issue? Well, what if you have another guy on your team that only wants to play as Glaz and only Glaz? Now, Glaz isn't worthless. He has his place. But what if you need a Thatcher? What if you need to have an important operator that synergizes with someone else on your team? You ask him nicely, hey, would you mind playing Thatcher? And he just flat out refuses. No, I want to play as Glaz. I want the Glaz skin. I want to progress with Glaz. Well, what do you do at that point? I feel like as soon as you tie progression to specific operators, you're going to run into this problem. It's already kind of an issue now where people will only want to play as certain ops, but this would just take it a step further. Now, of course, this doesn't apply to everyone. There are people that want to get the win, and they're going to do everything they can to get the win, and they're going to mix it up, but you know there's going to be people out there that will only main one op because they want that reward at the end of the season. Now, one way that Ubisoft could work around this issue is by simply implementing something like they do in Overwatch, where at the end of a ranked match, you get a currency, and you can use that currency on the gold skin. So you can still show off, hey, I love to play as this character, but you don't always have to play that character to get that specific skin. Now, you might be thinking, well, wait a second, isn't that Renown? You're absolutely right. And so, hopefully you can kind of see where I'm coming from on this one. Now, one thing I wouldn't mind seeing is that if they did want to add in the specific operator skins, is make them look really cool, make them look incredible, but then tie it to just a really expensive Renown cost. So if you want to have that really awesome Thermite skin, you're going to have to spend like 50,000 Renown. I know that seems really expensive, but if you want to have that really awesome skin and show off that, hey, I'm I'm a Thermite main, I love to play as Thermite, well, then you're gonna have to spend a lot of renown on that. I feel like that might be a better solution. But yeah, guys, that is about it for today's episode of Sunday Mailbox. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know what you thought about what we discussed in today's video. Do you want Ubisoft focusing on bringing in more shield operators? How would you like them to go about it? Do you want there to be really cool, unique skins for all the operators that are really expensive to kind of show off that you like to play as them? Let me know down below in the comments. As always, if you would like to submit your own question for an upcoming episode, you can also leave a comment down below or by sending me a Facebook or Twitter message. But until tomorrow, guys, have a good one and take it easy.